Right now, we're many, many miles away from Compton on the streets of Westwood, where, as you can see, movies are a major diversion and neon is a way of life. Lottie, it's gaudy. Anyway, speaking of underground sounds, we recently ran into a public radio station DJ out here who not only buys the records she plays, but plays only the records she likes on the air. What a concept. Her name is Deirdre O'Donoghue, and this is her story.
I think commercial radio right now is stifled enormously. It's, you know, it's computerized playlists, it's call-out research, it's let's test everything. There's nothing, or seems to be very little, that's done by a gut instinct or an ear instinct.
Deirdre O'Donoghue definitely knows what she's talking about. After 5 years as a DJ at the powerhouse LA station KMET, she said goodbye to commercial radio with all of its format and playlist restrictions and followed her instincts to KCRW, a public radio station located on the campus of Santa Monica College, where she now hosts a freewheeling 3-hour nightly new music show called Snap.
I really love music. And I like to go out scouting and finding new things. And I have the attention span of a 3-year-old, so I always want to be hearing new things. So I go exploring and digging things up in all different places and finding bands like Look Blue, Go Purple from New Zealand.
Unhampered by corporate musical programming and its need to please the mainstream music industry, O'Donoghue is free to seek out adventurous new acts on her own.
I don't mind buying records. I don't mind supporting an artist or music that I like at all. And the best part of not having to deal with a record company that way is unless they're tuned in to what you're doing or what I'm doing, then for the sake of getting a free album, you've got to deal with jerks once or twice a week, every week of the year. I would much rather pay the $10 or $15 for an album or a CD.
500,000 listeners seem to love the stuff she spins, and sometimes her tastes are even supported by the national sales charts. Not that O'Donoghue pays much attention to such things.
I never see charts. Doesn't have anything to do with that. I'll be really surprised sometimes when someone will call me and they say, what are you playing that for? That's, you know, that's a huge hit single. I'll say, really? God, great.
Playing records is just a part of what O'Donoghue does, though. At KCRW, she also has access to a fully equipped recording studio, into which she brings such bands as The Church, That Petrol Emotion, and The Mighty Lemon Drops for impromptu performances.
We've got the engineers all in place. We're flying Downy Mildew, live on Snap.
Deirdre O'Donoghue could be spinning all the predictable hits at some safe and witless top 40 station, but there's a lot more to music than just the hits. And as radio programmers themselves would do well to realize, a lot more to rock and roll radio, too.
You've got a new album when you found something that you really like, you say, oh, you've got to hear this new thing. That's all I'm doing here. Every night is I've got to come in with this pile of records and cassettes and CDs and say, wait till you hear what I found.
Deirdre O'Donoghue of KCRW Public Radio in Los Angeles, a woman who will apparently play almost any kind of record. Although probably not the latest release by, say, Olivia Newton-John. Not that it matters a whole lot. Olivia is in the clothing business. As a matter of fact, this is her store, Koala Blue. Some pretty pricey Aussie threads in there. We're going to take a quick break right now, but we'll be back with Dred Zeppelin and some on-the-street reviews of the new Rolling Stones record when the Weekend Rock continues.